Welcome back YouTube, I have Ahmed again from In-Depth Tech Reviews, and in this video I will walk you through the new changes in Android 11 Developer Preview 2. And let me tell you that this update is big and has a lot of changes that you will definitely love it. If you are excited about the new Android version, you definitely need to check those new changes. So let's see what's new with the Developer Preview 2. But before getting started, let's make sure to subscribe and hit the bell icon to get notified every time I post a new video. So let's jump in. The first change I'm going to show you in Android 11 Developer Preview 2 is in the Styles and Wallpapers app. It got a complete revamp compared to the Android 10 version. So let me show you this. When you go to the Styles and the Wallpapers app on Android 11 and Android 10, you definitely can see the difference in how it looks. First of all, the current wallpaper is taking the top half of your screen, while on the Android 10 version is just taking a small part. And now the wallpaper categories are in square shapes. You only see part of the wallpaper, while on Android 10 you see the full wallpaper on the thumbnail of the category itself. And it's in rectangular shape, and you need to scroll about 3 to 4 times to see all the categories, while here you just need to scroll 1 time because it's consuming a lot less space. Another small change I'm going to show you under the wallpapers, if you go for example to the Come Alive category, here you have the Groove wallpaper. And if you want a different color from the same wallpaper, you need to go to Customize and choose the color you want. While on Android 11, Google removed this customization option and you just have them separated already. You don't need to go inside to customize first to get the color you want, but you will have the 3 colors on front of you straight away. You can choose it and set it directly. If we go back to the main screen of the Styles and Wallpapers app, now you have a new option called Clock, which is not on Android 10. And when you go to Clock, you should see different styles for the clock of your device. However, currently it doesn't have any other styles. At the moment, it only has the default style. And when you choose it and hit Apply, it just do nothing. But you get this tick sign to let you know that you are on this clock style. When it comes to the style tab, there is nothing new here. It's exactly the same. I went through all the styles. There are no new styles here. Next, the changes in the notifications and the notification shade. The first change I'm going to show you is the new animation you get when you pull down your notifications shade. So as you see here on Android 11, the animation is a lot slower and it has also a rolling effect to it. So for example, you see things like as if they are rolling on the screen, while here on Android 10 it goes down quicker and it doesn't have the same effect you get with Android 11. Another visual change related to the notifications shade: when you pull it down, the sections are now written in bigger font. So let me zoom in to show you this. As you see here, the word conversations is now bigger, and also alerting notifications, silent notifications, and so on. There is also an empty space around the section name with a transparent background that you can see through. For example, you can see here the icons on my home screen. But I found it a little bit confusing when you have a screen that already includes text and you get new and pull down your notifications shade, you will see a text on top of text, which is a little bit confusing. I hope Google will add some blur effect to the transparent background to make it a bit easier to read. When it comes to notifications, there are a huge amount of changes that Google added in Android 11 Developer Preview 2, so let me show them to you one by one. First, when you tap and hold on any notification under the Conversations section, you will have this new button that looks like an arrow, and it's actually called Important. When you tap this button, that means you are flagging your conversation as important, which means that this conversation will be on the top of your conversations. And secondly, if this contact has a picture assigned to it, it will show up here in your notifications bar. So you can immediately know that you have one important notification waiting for you without even pulling down your notification shade. And the normal notifications that are not flagged as important will only show you the app icon as usual. And it also works with WhatsApp. So as you see here, I have another picture on my notifications bar. And this is actually for a WhatsApp conversation that I flagged as important, as you see here. And it actually took the profile picture of the contact from WhatsApp and added it here in the notifications bar at the top. But the only issue with this feature at the moment, when you reply back to this notification, the profile picture disappears from the notifications bar and you get the normal WhatsApp icon at the top. However, if you want to get it back, you just need to dismiss this notification. And if you got it again, like this, you will see the same profile picture is back again on the notifications bar. Not only this, in Android 11 Developer Preview 2, when you go to the application settings and then go to notifications, now you have a new section called conversations. This section will include any active conversation you have in this app. And when you tap on it, you will have a lot of settings to choose from that are specific to this conversation only without impacting the whole WhatsApp application. For example, you can make this conversation important or not. You can make it silent or alerting. You can turn the bubbles on and off. You can turn pop on screen on and off, and also change how your content show on the lock screen, show notification dot, vibration. And also the best part here is assigning a special sound for this conversation only. And here you also have not a conversation option. When you tap on it, this conversation will not be special anymore, and the same WhatsApp or the normal WhatsApp settings will be applied to it, and it will appear under the chats section. However, if you want to get it back under conversation section, you can tap on it and choose this is a conversation, and it will appear back again under this section. And the best part in this feature is the ability to have special settings for special conversations without impacting the whole app, which is a really nice addition in Android 11 Developer Preview 2. Next is hide silent notifications from status bar. So if you go to settings, apps and notifications, and then go to notifications and go to advanced, now you have a new option called hide silent notifications in a status bar at the top, so you will not see icons from silent notifications here. Now I'm gonna show you a new feature that I'm 100% sure all of you will love it. So if you pull down the notification shade, you will have a new button here called history. If you compare that to Android 10, you will see manage, not history. When you tap on history, for the first time, this option will be turned off. This is called notification history, which means any notification you got on your phone, it will be saved here. So sometimes you dismiss notifications by mistake and you go crazy where you got this notification from. Now you will be able to easily know where you got this notification from by going to the history of notifications here, by pulling down the notification shade, tap on history, and you will have all the history of your notifications showing up here. And the first thing that came up to my mind, what if somebody sent me a message on WhatsApp like this and decided to delete this message later before I see it? Will I still be able to see it under history? So the answer is no. Actually, Google took in consideration the privacy of people, so now the message doesn't appear in the notification shade and also doesn't appear under history. So enough with the notifications, and let's move on to the other changes. And the next change here is related to the keyboard. Now the keyboard in Android 11 has a new animation. So if you tap the text area, the keyboard will slide up, and if you dismiss it, it will slide down. While on Android 10, it acts differently. When you tap it, it slides up, but when you dismiss it, it disappears or fades away. But here it slides up and slides down, and it looks more refined than Android 10. So here in Android 10, it slides up quickly, but here it's kind of a slower animation that gives a really nice look to the device. Next, the change is under settings. When you go to settings, now you will see The Wi-Fi and the Bluetooth options are permanent. They don't go away. You can turn the Wi-Fi on and off, or you can go inside the Wi-Fi settings. For the Bluetooth, you can also go to the Bluetooth devices, or you can tap the add button straight away to add a new Bluetooth device without the need to go inside Bluetooth first. Also keep in mind that if you have Bluetooth turned off and you tap on the add button, it turns on the Bluetooth automatically and it will start searching for the device. The next change is in the volume menu. When you click the volume rocker and tap on the more volume controls button, here on Android 10, as you see, the card is a lot bigger than on Android 11, so it's easier for you to reach the controls with one hand on Android 11, while on Android 10 it's taking too much space from the screen and it's not easy for you to change the media volume if you are using the phone with one hand. Another change here is the new icons that showing beside each option, while here you only have text, so it looks better here. And also there is a small text change here, ring and notification volume instead of ring volume, and that's pretty much it. Another new change that I'm sure you will like it is related to the screen recording. When you tap the screen recording button, you will see a new overlay menu that looks a lot cleaner than before, and it has a new icon that looks like a red dot instead of the cast icon, which makes more sense now. And now you have the option to record audio and also show touches if you want. Once you hit start, you will get a countdown at the top right corner. Let me show it to you. So I'm gonna hit start and you see the counter is saying 3, 2, 1, and then the record icon stays here. Now if you want to stop the recording, you will get this red notification. Once you tap on it, the recording will stop. You don't need to expand it. So once I tap on it, it will stop the recording and the icon disappeared. And now you can record audio while recording your screen. So as you can hear, it picked up my voice. However, the sound quality is very poor, and I hope Google will work on this in the future. Another new option under security, if you go to settings, then security, advanced, and you have here a new option called confirm SIM deletion, which means it will confirm before deleting your eSIM from the device. In Android 11 developer preview 2, the Pixel 4 got the option that require eyes to be open under face unlock settings, which means we are going to get it very soon in future updates in Android 10. So I hope Google will release it with the next security update in April. And finally, the wireless debugging. That's really nice for developers especially. You can go or activate that debugging mode using the Wi-Fi without the need to connect your phone using the USB, which is a really nice addition for developers. So that's pretty much it for today. Those are all the changes I managed to get my hands on in Android 11 developer preview 2. And please let me know in the comments if I missed anything and share with me your opinions about this big update. For me, I do like most of the changes I saw in Android 11 developer preview 2, and that makes Android 11 very promising, and I'm excited to get the final version on my device. So thank you so much for watching, and I hope you like my video, and if you do, please hit the thumbs up and subscribe for more videos. Thank you for watching.